The Legend of the Pineapple. Once upon a time, in a small village in the Philippines, there was a naughty girl. Her name was Piña. Whenever her nanay cooked their supper, she asked Piña for help. "Piña," she said, "please could you stir this pot for me?"
"But where is the spoon, nanay?"
Piña would say. "Look with your eyes and not with your mouth," nanay replied. But by then, Piña had already skipped away to watch monkey-eating eagles flying in the sky. So her poor nanay had to stir the pot herself. Whenever her nanay cleaned their bamboo hut, she asked Piña for help. "Piña," she said, "please could you sweep the floor for me?"
"Where is the broom, nanay?"
Piña would say. "Look with your eyes and not with your mouth," her nanay replied. But by then, Piña had already skipped away to watch the sunset. Whenever she was gardening, nanay asked Piña for help. "Piña," she said, "please could you water the tomato plants for me?"
"Where is the watering can?"
Piña would say. "Look with your eyes and not with your mouth," her nanay replied. But by then, Piña had already skipped away to play under the coconut trees. So her poor nanay had to water the tomato plants herself. One day, an old woman knocked on their door. "Been traveling for many miles," she said. "I am so weary. Would you let me rest in your house before I go on with my journey?" "Of course," Piña's nanay said. "Come in, come in." The old woman took a seat and nanay called for Piña. "Piña, please could you get a fan? This tired lady is very hot."
"Where is the fan, nanay?"
Piña said. "Look with your eyes and not with your mouth," nanay replied. But Piña had already wandered out to the backyard. The old lady sighed, and nanay fetched the fan herself. Nanay prepared a large tray of delicious rice cakes for the old lady. Piña appeared at the door.
"Rice cakes,"
Piña said. "Piña, I'm so glad you're here. Please, could you fetch a glass of water for this tired lady?"
"Where is the glass of water, nanay?"
Piña said. "Look with your eyes and not with your mouth," nanay replied. But by then, Piña had already skipped away to visit the water buffaloes in their mud holes. The old woman frowned, and nanay fetched the glass of water herself.
"Your little girl should be more helpful," the old woman said.
Nanay could not answer.
"I know many things," the old woman said, "and one of the things I know is that your daughter does this to you all the time."
Nanay was ashamed and began to feel a little bit afraid.
"You have been so kind to me," the old woman said. "I want to help you." Then in a quiet voice, she whispered, "Lovely lady, kindly mother, never deserved such a worthless daughter. A daughter who pretended not to see all the tasks she wished to flee. May you forget her lazy ways when these riches take her place."
With that, the old woman disappeared, for she was really a witch in disguise. Piña's nanay was so frightened she ran out onto the road. "Piña," she called, "Piña!" But Piña had disappeared. The next day, a mysterious plant began to grow next to their bamboo hut. From the plant, grew a large fruit, the shape of a human head. And on the fruit were prickles that looked like hundreds of eyes watching blindly as Nanai went about her chores. She propagated the fruit, which was sweet on the inside, but tough and spiny on the outside. Pinya was what Nanai called the fruit, because its eyes reminded her of the time she told her missing daughter, "Look with your eyes and not with your mouth." Everyone else called it the pineapple, even though it was much sweeter than an apple, and it didn't grow tall like a pine tree. Growing the pinya brought Nanai many riches, for people from near and far came to taste its gorgeous flavor. There was no fruit like it in the whole wide world. But Nanai would have given it all up to have her naughty little girl back.